All right, cool. So, Randy Lewis, welcome to my garage. This is where I build my FD cars. I got all the tools I need to get this stuff done. MIG welder, TIG welder, all the tools, little presses and stuff like that. This car is garage built by me, 100%. I've done everything from the paint to the cage to the engine swap, everything. For this year we're running Formula D Pro 2 2018. I ran in 2016. We did a pretty well job. I didn't really want to change the car too much for this season because it just worked really well, and I didn't want to change it and have to do a lot of tuning and
all of the extra work.
Yeah, just extra work, research, shit like that. So anyways, it's a 2JZ. It's got a Garrett GTX 48R turbo. Stock long block. I try to keep that simple because if I blow it up, I got an extra one in the corner. So, who cares? It's a throwaway motor. We put a big radiator in it. I haven't got my fan shroud set up in it yet, but I'm going to. That's kind of like next week's thing. I think I got Deechwork 1000cc injectors running on 110 fuel. It's a pretty basic setup. It makes 501 horsepower at 18 pounds boost. I mean, I can turn it up, I just choose not to. You don't really need the power if you're using it at all. So, Super Duke kit, Origin wide body, pretty simple setup. Run Neo Motorsport brakes. Their brake kit's pretty cool if you guys want to check them out. They sell that stuff. The Neo Motorsport coilovers are really good. I've been running them since 2013. It handles really well on the track, off the track, streets, everything. This year, I decided to put new doors on it. It's not these, I still gotta paint them. I ran gutted doors, and honestly, it sucks. I don't recommend it to anybody. I've got the new doors, I got the roll-up windows, all the door seals, everything like that. Kind of turn it almost back into a street car. In a way, but we'll see. Back behind the 2J, it's a Dogbox G-Force 4-speed transmission. I've had it in there since 2016. They're awesome. I've never had any problems with it. Hurst 4-speed, pull ball grip, just pretty simple setup. Simple gauges, nothing crazy. Then I go to the Winters quick change diff. And you probably won't be able to see it back here. Maybe. You can kind of poke it down in there, you can kind of see it sitting there. Those discs are really badass. You can change out your gearings in maybe 10 minutes at the track. It's super awesome. Just run a radium fuel cell setup with the, ATL tank with the radium setup in it. I run about, I think there's 3 Walbro 400 fuel pumps in there powering this thing to keep it, keep fuel in it. This is the fabrication I did this year. It was a little different. I wanted to isolate the tank, so if I rub a wall, it can collapse into the tank and won't hurt nothing in here. And then the same thing was with the bash bar setup. I kept it also, it's all crushable. You can't run the springs anymore to run walls, because they changed the rule book. So if I was to tap a wall, it can collapse in without tearing up everything in the car. I'm kind of proud of that. Take a good hit. And that's pretty much it on the car. I mean, it's pretty basic 240SX. I mean, dual brakes in the back, the Z32 setup, the hydro. It's nothing crazy. I got drive shaft shop axles. They hold up pretty much the best compared to other people's stuff. OMP seats, they're a pretty good brand. Relatively priced right. You can get them easy, get them shipped to you. And then that's about it for the car. I mean, it's, I just got to do a little bit of work to it and finish it up and get it ready for the season. So, a little bit of something to work on. And then we got the other stuff outside. It's kind of fun to show. Not a lot of people know about it.
The garage.
So this is the car I built over the last year. This is a 90 cylinder coupe, pretty basic. I bought the car down in Georgia, so it's got no rust. It was unmolested, super clean. I cut the firewall out of it, right-hand drive swapped it. Then I put a Neo RB25 swap into it. Got it all wired up. basic setup. This is an RB25 Neo motor that comes out of the R34s. All I did was put an intake on it, some custom intercooler piping. Tried to keep it as stock as I can, so you know I could just drive it a good few miles. And, you know, just kind of did a wire tuck. It still needs to be finished. Still kind of work on it. As you can see, it's kind of in pieces. I was driving for a little while, but I hooked it up with a Spirit wide body kit, and then I ordered a Origin Type 3 body kit for it, which will be coming within the next couple weeks. I'm gonna try to get it painted and put on around the springtime. So that's kind of it for me. This is my house, my garage. You know, just simple setup. You know, everybody can. You know, it's just depending on what you want to do with your cars, your drifting. You know, anybody can do it with whatever you have. You know, I started out even smaller than this. When I went in the FD the first time, I had a 96 Dodge Cummins. I was pulling around an open trailer. Now I'm sitting here, you know, I earn money, I work my ass off, and this is what I do with the cash I make. So, something everybody can think about, you know, just doing your own work, and, you know, that's the best way to do it, really. I mean, you can always pay someone to build their car, but in the end, you're always more proud of it when you're good, you know, you do it yourself. So, yeah.
Cool. Shout out to sponsors and stuff like that.
Yeah, I like to throw out some shout out to my sponsors. I only have a couple. I got Driftworks. The guys are great. They're wide, you know, their knuckles are awesome. I love them. I've never had a problem with them. We're on the same knuckles since 2012 on this car, so, you know, it'll put the heart on any Wise Fab kit. Autolite, Fram, you know, they got their plugs. Great, keeps power to the wheels in this thing. I've never, you know, the oil filters, you know, good stuff. Neo Motorsport, suspension brakes, you know, they hit you up, or hit them up, mention my name, they'll hook you up on, you know, a good, decent deal. They got a contingency program this year, they started back up, so, you know, if you get on with that, they'll pay you some money if you podium at even just small events like Pro-Am, you know, stuff like that. And then I got a new sponsor this year. It's Quick Style Motorsports. They import cars. They get you hooked up on some body kits, stuff like that. They're pretty cool guys. You know, hit them up, mention my name. You know, they'll totally appreciate it. Hook you up for some stickers at the very least, probably. So, that's about it for the sponsors. I hit up people, but they don't really care about Pro 2. So, but yeah, that's it. I mean, this is the place.
Cool. All right, where can they find you at?
You can look me up on Facebook, it's Angel Lewis, or Instagram, AngelLewis63, or that's my race page on Instagram is Wing It Motorsports. That's where I'm doing most of my media now and everything. I'm trying to keep it separate from my actual private stuff, but that's where we do all the videos. That's where everything like that's going to be posted to, updates on the car, events, where I'm going to be, that kind of thing, you know, like Grid Life. We're going to be there this year, all of FD Pro 2 events, and then I'll probably have the black car at all the MI Drift events, you know, when I'm in town and not working kind of thing. So, that's where you get me on that.
Awesome. All right. That is Andrew Lewis's car for Pro 2. Can't wait to see him out there this year.